This is a small stepper motor, and this is also a stepper motor, and this. Maybe this chicken also wants to learn something about stepper motors. Let's teach him then. Usually you can find stepper motors with 4 wires and 6 wires. This stepper motor on my right side has 4 wires, so it is very easy to connect with any stepper motor driver. While this stepper motor has 6 wires, so I will need to figure out which of these wires are the correct 4 wires to connect with this A4988. Actually, even the largest stepper motor drivers such as TB6560 or TB6600 are only compatible with 4 wire stepper motors. I will now show you how to find the wire pairs using this multimeter. Or maybe I will just throw it away and tell you how to find the wires without it. Just grab any of the wires and connect it with another wire and rotate the router. If it is still free, then connect this wire with the second wire and try to rotate. You can see it is a bit hard to move this router now. I will release the wires, and again you can see it is now easily rotating. Again I will short these wires just to confirm. As you can see, the router is again locked. Congratulations, we found our first pair. Since this motor only has 4 wires, so if we found our first pair, then the remaining 2 wires must be the second pair. See, why would you need a multimeter for such an easy job then? Now I will use the same method to find the correct wire pairs for this 6 wires stepper motor. The method is basically the same, but you will now need to feel the locking force difference. That is because although there are still 2 coils in the stepper motor, but each coil has a center tapped wire which is connected with both outside wires as well. So basically we will first find the 3 wires from the same coil. Then we will separate the center tap wire for both coils. Shorting these 3 wires in any order will result in motor locking, because the center tap short with any outside wire will have less locking force, but it will still lock the router a bit. So as you can see, I have found the 3 wires here, and these 3 wires must be the second pair. So now the next thing is to find the center taps and then set aside those center tap wires, because we won't need those wires. We only need the outside wires for each coil. As you can see, I have shorted the 2 wires from these 3 and felt the force. Again I shorted these 2 wires and felt the force, and now I am shorting these 2 wires. As you can see, you can even visually feel the difference, because the torque is much higher, the locking force is much higher when I short these 2 wires. So that means the white wire was the center tap. Again I will use same method with the second coil. I have felt the force. Now I will connect the other 2 wires and again feel the torque force. Sorry about that. Again I will, as you can see, the torque seems to be higher, the locking force is a bit higher on these 2 wires. So I have set the center tap wire aside, and we found the correct 4 wires. Now, just for the peace of mind, I am now going to test my findings. As you can see, these two wires show 32 ohm. Now, if I connect it with the center tape wire, it should show the half of 32. Yes, as you can see, it is showing 16 ohms. That is because this wire is center tap in this coil. Similarly, I am again going to test the second coil which we found. Again, you can see 32 ohms here. Okay, that's it for today. So if you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and take care of yourself and your family. See you again with another video.